So my question is there a difference in the mindset between the BJP party and the BJP government on Kashmir?
Well, Dr. Anna is a Kashmiri.
Yes.
And he's referring to Mr. Yashwant Sinha, obviously.
Yes. As far as dialogue with different groups in the valley is concerned, in our common minimum program, we have clearly stated that the state government is open, why should I say open, is duty bound to talk to all the different stakeholders in the state. And we have added the phrase, including Hurriyat. They are a part and parcel of Jammu and Kashmir state's citizenry. They have every right to talk to the government. Government is obliged to talk to them. They will any time talk to those people. But as far as government of India's policy is concerned, talks for the sake of talks are just to please some intellectual sitting in TV studios in Delhi. It would not happen that way. If somebody wants to talk to the government, he also has to listen to the government. Talks cannot be a one-way road. You have pathar in your hands. You promote violence. You fly Pakistani flags. And you say, talk to me. This is a different government. You cannot talk that way. You want to talk? You show that sincerity. That sincerity is lacking in the separatist leadership in the Kashmir Valley. So any question of whether government of India wants to talk or not talk doesn't arise as long as the leadership, separatist leadership there continues with this kind of policy of promoting terrorism. You see, making innocent citizens scapegoats in their game is unacceptable to us. That must stop first before anybody talking about talks.
Let me ask you a question. There are about 250 militants right now operating in the valley. About 100 are foreign and about 150 are local Kashmiri militants. You talked about neutralizing the last militant. Are you talking about the Indian Kashmiri militants also? A. B. Is there any difference between your government and the previous government in the way it treats local Kashmiri militants?
I don't qualify militant with this militant, that militant. Militant is a militant. Somebody who holds a gun in his hands. Will you agree him in this hall or not? Will you not throw him out of this hall if he wields a gun in your hands? See, the last man, you cannot say that he's sitting in the last row, what is your problem? No, that is not acceptable in a either you follow democratic system, you go to the government of the day, talk to them, or face it. When I say militants, no qualifications. Militant is that person who is wielding a weapon in his hands and killing people, whether innocent or not innocent. I mean, these are all the judgments one makes. So, how do you explain the killing of that Lieutenant Fayyaz few days ago? So, no question of qualifying militants as local, outsider, this and that. If you are a militant, you have to be ready for the consequences.
So you will not treat Indian militants as misguided youth and try and bring them in the mainstream as used to be?
Now, as I said, I don't qualify anybody as Indian militant and foreign militant.
So at the moment, the moment he picks up a gun, he will be neutralized.
A gun against the state and the people
right.
is not accepted in our system.